This is a story of a man who is a chemist, a polyglot, a physician, and the father of homeopathy. The legend who stood up strong and said, "Be brave to be wise." So, we thought of doing this puppet show depicting the life of Hahnemann in a nutshell. In town of Saxony, Meissen, Germany, there lived a couple named Christian Gottfried Hahnemann and Johanna Christiana, who were blessed with a child. The child was born on 10th April 1755, midnight, and was named Christian Frederick Samuel Hahnemann. Hahnemann's father taught him the moral of his life: prove all things and hold fast that which is good. On 28th July 1767, he was sent to a town school. Later, he got shifted to Prince School and became favorite of Magister Muller and also to his teachers. Muller trained Hahnemann with many languages. The sad part is, because of the family's poor economical status, his father terminated him. His father joined him in the porcelain factory nearby. As Hahnemann is a very much loved student, lecturers and students helped him to join school again. In this school, he presented his first oration, The Wonderful Construction of Human Hand. 1775 AD, with 20 thalers in his pocket, 20-year-old Hahnemann entered Leipzig University. To study medical advancement, he went to Vienna and joined hospital, Brothers of Mercy. Here, he became a favorite pupil of von Quaden. In the year 1779 AD, 24-year-old Hahnemann received his degree from Erlangen University. On 17th November 1782 AD, Hahnemann married Johanna Leopoldin Henrietta Putschler. In 1784, the couple were blessed with their first child, Henrietta. Hahnemann has a great interest in chemistry. And during the years 1785 to 1792, he translated 4,700 pages. He published Friend of Health in the year 1789. Was dissatisfied with the cruel state of medicine in his times, and particularly objected to the practices such as bloodletting and practice of drilling the holes in person. He claimed that the medicine he had been taught to practice sometimes did the patient more harm than good. And he left his practice and started translating books. While translating William Hewlin's A Treatise on Materia Medica, Hahnemann encountered the claim that cinchona, the bark of Peruvian tree, was effective in treating malaria because of its bitterness. Hahnemann started experimenting of cinchona bark and started proving it. He observed malaria-like symptoms and also tried on other members. This led him to postulate a healing principle: that which can produce a set of symptoms in a healthy individual can treat a sick individual who is manifesting a similar set of symptoms. This principle, like cures like, became the basic for the approach to medicine, which he gave the name homeopathy. Because of poverty and to fulfill needs, Hahnemann accepted offer as in charge of Georgenthal. Here, he cured Minister Klockenberg, who was said untreatable by others. Later. And finally, discovery of homeopathy in the year 1796. Between the year 1790 to 1805 AD, Hahnemann published around 5,500 printed pages of work. In 1805 AD, Medicine of Experience. In 1810 AD, the first edition of Organon of Medicine was published. Hahnemann was well known as translator, but the publications of Organon changed the life of Hahnemann. On 28 Jan 1835 in Croydon, Hahnemann married Mary Milani. This second marriage brought bright fortune to Hahnemann and couple left to Paris. Even his wife Milani started practice of homeopathy. Hahnemann led a happy life in his final days. Here are the few contributions of Hahnemann. He wrote letter to Bonninghausen saying that, "I am at work on 6th edition of Organon, to which I devote several hours on Sundays and Thursdays. All other times required to treat patients.